This Ableton Live tutorial will look at music production for beginners using Ableton Live 10 Lite. Now, Ableton Live Lite is a free DAW or digital audio workstation, and it's included with many pieces of hardware, and it's even included in some music production software bundles. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and on this channel, I do audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. Now, like I said earlier, today I'm looking at Ableton Live 10, specifically the Ableton Live Lite version of Live 10. If you're new to music production or digital audio workstations, but you have a copy of Ableton Live Lite that's come with some hardware or software that you purchased, and you're wondering what it's all about, then this video is for you. Now, here's what I'm going to go over in this Ableton Live tutorial. First, I'm going to quickly go over some of the differences between Ableton Live Lite and Ableton Live 10 Standard, and then I'm going to show you how to set up your audio interface and your MIDI controller. And after that, we'll do some audio recording and some MIDI recording using virtual instruments. After that, I'm going to show you how to add some effects onto your tracks. And then we're going to have some fun by bringing in your own loops and beats into the session view and using that to create music. And then finally, I'm going to show you how to export your tracks so you can send them to your friends or upload them to the internet or whatever it is you want to do with them. So let's jump into this great free DAW. So first, I want to quickly go over the differences of Live Lite versus Ableton Live 10 Standard, which is the current version as of this recording. With Live Lite, you get all of the same workflows, instruments, and effects as the standard version of Ableton Live. However, you can only have up to 8 audio and MIDI tracks. This is still manageable for creating music, and just like the standard version, you can use Ableton Live Lite like a traditional DAW and record and edit on a linear timeline, or you can start to build songs using the session view. The instruments and the effects that it comes with are great, but you can also add third-party plugins to Ableton Live Lite. So really, the biggest difference is the track count. Now let's open up Ableton Live Lite and quickly get our audio interface and MIDI keyboard set up. So you want to go up to Options, and then Preferences, and then go over to the Audio tab. Click on that, and in Driver Type, you want to change that to ASIO. And then in Audio Device, click on it and find your audio interface in the drop-down menu. You shouldn't need to adjust anything else in here. So that's it for the audio interface setup. Now let's go over to the Link MIDI tab, and then in here, you want to go to Input, and click on where it says None, and your MIDI keyboard or MIDI controller should show up here. There are also some pre-configured control surface mappings if you click on the Control Surface drop-down menu and bring down the menu here, and if yours is in here, you can click on that as well. And once you're done that, we can close this out and go back to the main window. Ableton Live typically defaults to the session view, which is this view here. We're going to come back to that in a bit, but right now let's change it to the arrangement view, which is more like a typical DAW. So you want to click on this button over here. That brings us to the arrangement view. If you've worked in any other audio production software, this should look fairly familiar to you. I'm going to click over here to close the browser for now. We'll bring it back up later, but I don't need it right now. So right now we're going to look at recording audio into Ableton Live Lite. So go down to one of these audio tracks here. If for some reason you don't have audio tracks preloaded, then you can always go up to Create and then go to Insert Audio Track. And depending on what input of your audio interface you plan on recording, you can click here to change it to Input 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever input you have, or you can even have it as a stereo input with 1 and 2 feeding it. So select your input. I'm going to choose input 1. Once you've selected your input, arm the track for recording by clicking on the circle button right here, and it should turn red when it's armed to record. And now you should see your levels in the little meter on the side. If you're happy with your levels, you can now record. If you're recording guitar or something where you want to keep beat, I recommend enabling the metronome by clicking here. There's also some options that you can choose if you click on the little arrow down. I like to do a count in of one bar. Now let's hit the record button and record some audio. If you're happy with your take, you can disarm the track from recording by clicking on the little circle again. And we can now move on to recording MIDI. So let's open our browser again by clicking over here. And then on the far left, you want to click on Instruments. I'm going to click on Instrument Rack. And as you can see, there are multiple options to choose from. But I'm going to select a bass. You can either drag and drop this into the header of a MIDI track over here, and you'll see it load down there. Or if you are clicked on a MIDI track already, you can drag and drop it into the bottom here. So now we look, our MIDI track is armed for recording already, which is good. Now all we have to do is hit the record button to start recording. Once you're done recording, you'll have a MIDI clip in your timeline here. Once you double click on it, you'll see that your piano roll opens up at the bottom here. And you can adjust your notes down here. You can move them around. You can adjust the velocity if you like. Or if you click on the little pencil tool up here, you can even draw in more notes if you really want to. And you can move your clip around on the timeline however you like. And you can duplicate it by either holding down Control on your computer keyboard, clicking and dragging, or by right-clicking, copy, and then right-clicking, paste. Now let's look at bringing an effect onto a track. On my guitar track that I just recorded, I'm going to add an audio effect. You can bring in third-party VSTs if you want. You just need to set your VST plugin folder in the preferences. Or you can use some of the many plugins that Ableton Live comes with. So for this, I'm going to use an Ableton plugin. Click on Audio Effects over here on the left, and I'm going to go to Audio Effect Rack, then Amp Simulation, and then I'm going to choose one of these presets here. I'll just drag it over onto the header of the track, and now you can see all the controls down there. Let's hear what that sounds like. All right, it's not the greatest song, as I just quickly whipped it up on the fly, but let's say I don't mind that amp simulation sound, so we'll leave it like that. You can have more than one effect on a track. Just find another effect and drag it down into here. And now we have two effects, and you can keep adding more and more effects down at the bottom there. You can even rearrange the order that they're in by clicking and dragging it to the front like that. Now we have our compressor in front of our amp simulator. Now let's move on to the session view with some of your own loops and sounds. This is a lot of fun, so I'm going to start a new project for this. If you need to add your folder where all your loops and samples are, you just easily click on Add Folder, and then find wherever it is on your computer, and then click on Select Folder. I already have mine added here. Ableton does come with its own library of sounds, so you can use those right out of the box. So I want to start out with a drum beat, so you can audition sounds just by clicking on them. All right, let's say I like this one here. Let's drag that over onto a MIDI track, like this. Now I can play it. And while I'm playing that, I can audition other sounds. Now, let's say I like that one. I'm going to drag that over here. All right, so I have a few samples loaded into my tracks here, and I want to start creating a song out of using these. So what I'm going to do is hit the record button and start my drum beat like this. Now let's start to add some of these other parts in. All okay, well, let's say we just did a whole big session like that and we had all kinds of stuff and we wanted to play back what we just did here. Go back up to your arrangement view by clicking here and you'll see that all these clips are in the arrangement now. And if you want to listen to the session that you just recorded, you would click on this red button here. Then you can listen back to that session that you just played around with. And obviously you can add more loops in there and change around however you like. And let's say you're happy with this and you want to send it to some friends or upload it to SoundCloud or wherever, you'll need to export this into an audio file. So go up to File, then click on Export Audio. And you'll want to make sure that you're exporting the master, that way you get all of the sounds in here. And you have a couple of options for the file type. You have your WAV file plus some others in there, and also your MP3. So you can actually click on MP3 and export it as WAV and as MP3, or you can turn off WAV and just export it as MP3, or just export it as WAV, whatever you want. I'm just going to export it as an MP3. Once you're ready here, click on Export, find wherever you want to save it, click Save. And that's it. Click up here to check out some great free VST instruments, or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.